What's up, y'all? It's your boy, TyLoTheGentleman. And for all y'all that want a piece of One Piece, welcome to Wano Piece. Before we even start this video, I want to give a shout out to the Wano Piece Pirate Crew for liking this video before it even starts. If you want to be a member of the Wano Piece Pirate Crew, hit that subscribe button below.
Do it! Just do it!
Follow me on Instagram at Wano_Piece for updates on the channel, One Piece memes, One Piece cosplay, and One Piece artwork. This week, we are recapping chapters 351 through 360. Alright, so when we last left off, Franky and Usopp are having a conversation. Franky starts dismantling the Going Merry because he's saying that the ship has reached its limit. He just starts breaking it apart. Usopp starts crying, telling him to stop, trying to fight him. And Franky tells Usopp that this is the end for the ship. Usopp doesn't want to believe it, but he already knows that. He says he already knows that, but he said he saw someone on the ship one day trying to fix the ship. Remember we spoke about that in Alabasta? And it was actually the Going Merry spirit, also known as a Klabautermann. The spirit of the ship comes and helps you get to one final destination or place. What Franky said is he had heard rumors of it from sailors before, but what this means is that the ship cared about, or the ship was treated so well by its owners that it came to life in order to make sure they got to where they needed to be safely. Okay, the CP9 show up to Franky's base and they capture Usopp and they capture Franky because Franky has the blueprint or knows where the blueprint is. Their goal is to get them to Eni's lobby. Franky's real name is Cutty Flam, and that's the name he went with. Now, during all this stuff that happens, the CP9 start reminding him of a crime he committed, which actually wasn't committed by him. It was actually committed by CP5 agents. The whole conspiracy thing we got going on. So, Iceberg and Franky were the disciples of a guy named Tom. Tom is a merman, like a merman, a pufferfish merman. He owned Tom's workers, right? So he had workers and they all were building ships and stuff like that. So eventually he has to stand trial because he built Goldie Roger's ship. Now usually it wouldn't matter if a shipwright made a pirate ship. It's just that this was the Pirate King and Goldie Roger. They were just coming to get everybody. This was a special case, so they sentenced him to execution. Now what happens is he brings up to the judge that, hey, I have an idea for a sea train. You won't need log poses, you won't need ships. The sea train will take you from island to island, all these connecting islands. So they pushed his sentence back 10 years. During his 10 years, Franky's making like battle Frankies, all these different types of ships and war machines. Iceberg is telling him, yo man, you shouldn't be doing that. You shouldn't be leaving these around. It's very dangerous. And then Tom is just teaching them that, hey, you have to take responsibility for what you create. So Tom, after his 10 years are up, he makes the ship, the Puffin Tom. He makes this train. And the train goes from island to island and it brings back it helps the islands flourish again. Slow start, but it slowly starts to help the islands flourish. Now, they were going to pardon Tom, but the CP5 came and they were begging. Spandam was trying to negotiate Tom to give him the blueprints for the Pluton. Now, the Pluton is needed in order to fight back against a different ancient weapon. So if that ancient weapon is created, the Pluton was created to defend against it. He didn't want to give that to the government because he felt like the government might not use it for the right means. What happens next is, since he won't give it to Spandam, Spandam frames them, uses the battle Frankies to attack the judge and the island just before he was getting pardoned. So when he goes to trial, he asks that the sea train pardons him, Franky, and Iceberg from that crime, but he still had to go get executed for the crime of building Goldie Roger's ship. Eni's lobby is a prison controlled by the world government, and no one has been able to get back from there. Okay, Tom kept using the word Don as a badge of courage, like as a symbol of something like, you know, this, like, it's your word is your bond. He's using this word Don. I'm not sure if that has anything to do with Luffy, Monkey D. Luffy, Goldie Roger. I have no idea if that has anything to do with that, Porcus D. Ace. But, yeah, that word Don sounds like it means some serious business.
Think about it.
Okay, so before they leave to take Tom, Franky messes up Spandam's face. And then he runs away, he gets in front of the train, and tries to shoot it with a rocket launcher and gets ran over by the train.
That's a lot of damage.
Because the way Tom built the train is almost indestructible, and it has these things on the tracks that make the Sea King stay away from it. So he gets ran over, everyone thinks he's dead. And before that, Tom gave him an iceberg, the blueprints for the Pluton, right? Of course, Franky wants to build it, but you can't, you know, it's a whole different thing. But Franky ends up dying, but we find out Franky doesn't actually die. He goes by the name Franky because Iceberg gave him that nickname. He told him don't use Cutty Flam because the officers that were looking for Tom are also now looking for him. So the CP9 is now run by that CP5 agent Spandam. So now he's the commander-in-chief of the CP9. So it's the same officer that couldn't get the info from Tom is trying to get the info from Iceberg. Now they're going to try and get the info from Franky because they believe Iceberg's dead. Iceberg and Pauly aren't dead because Chopper saved them from the fire. Now, when they come to capture Franky and Usopp, they drop the Going Merry into the sea. I think that's going to be it for the Going Merry. Unless its spirit animal comes back again and pops up to save them just in time, I don't know. But it looked like there was nobody driving the boat, so it looks like it's just gonna rock around in the sea till it meets an unfortunate end or sinks. Okay, so we find out that the only reason that Nico Robin is going against her crew is because she has to, or the CP9 can call a buster call on the Straw Hat Pirates.
Why are you running? Why are you running?
What a buster call is five lieutenant generals and 10 warships can come to get the Straw Hat Pirates. The CP9 has this power because Admiral Aokiji gave them this power. So in order for them not to use that, Nico Robin has to do what they say. So in a way, she's sacrificing everything and everybody, the fate of the world, for her pirate crew.
Explosion.
So this whole time, Sanji, remember him and Chopper split up? Sanji has been waiting for Nico Robin at the train station. So he's waiting for her to find out exactly what's going on. So he sees Nico Robin getting on the train with the CP9 agents, with Usopp, and with Franky all on board. Zoro and Luffy are stuck. Everyone's looking for Zoro and Luffy. And we'll find out what happens next in the next video. Let me catch you up on the short comics. Alright, so there's this house in the jungle. It's definitely made out of a candle, so I know it's Mr. 3. And we also see that Miss Golden Week has just received a newspaper. And we'll find out what that newspaper had on it in the next video. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what was your favorite part of these 10 chapters. The Grand Line is a rough place. You're gonna need a pirate crew. Join the Wano Peace Pirate Crew today by hitting that subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this one. Peace.